Now we'll start with the topic of electromagnetic interactions, and we'll start with the study of some facts about electromagnetic interactions, which are quite useful in analyzing different kind of situations related to electromagnetic forces. The very first point we'll study about is a static charge produces only electric field in its surrounding, and only external electric field can exert a force on a static charge. This is a point which we already discussed in the section of electrostatics. Let's discuss once again. If we are given with a charge at rest, this is a plus Q charge, then we know it produces an electric field in its surrounding and radially outward direction. Say if E vector is the electric field which it produces, and say an external electric field E external vector is applied, then this external electric field will interact with the electric field of this charge, and hence this charge experiences a force due to the external field. And say we apply a magnetic field induction B external vector over here, then we can say as charge does not produce its own magnetic induction, there won't be any interaction of this external field, magnetic field, with the electric field or any other field produced by the charge, because it can interact only with the magnetic field produced by any source. So here there is no magnetic field, so we can say that external magnetic field can never exert a force on a static charge. Second point, if we discuss about a moving charge, we can write a fact that a moving charge produces both electric field and magnetic field in its surrounding, and we can see that both electric field and magnetic field can exert force on the moving charge. Here you can see if we are having a charge plus Q moving with a velocity V, then we know it produces E vector in its surrounding, as well as it produces B vector in the surrounding, which is given by Bio-Savart's law we already studied in the previous section. And in this situation, if an external electric field E external vector and an external magnetic field B external vector is applied, then both of these external fields can interact with the electric and magnetic fields produced by the moving charge. So both of these will exert a force on this moving charge. So we can say a moving charge produces both field in the surrounding, that's why it experiences a force due to both kind of external fields. There is one more point, let's continue on the next sheet. Let's continue with the third point, which is about a current carrying wire, for which we can write that a current carrying wire produces only magnetic field in its surrounding and only external magnetic field can exert a force on the current carrying wire, or we can also write current carrying conductor. This is because if we are given with a current carrying wire, as net charge on the wire is zero in its surrounding, net electric field is zero, as it does not produce any electric field because total charge on the wire is zero. But as there are moving charges, it produces magnetic field in its surrounding. So when an external magnetic field B external vector is applied, this external magnetic field will interact with the magnetic induction produced by the wire, and hence due to this interaction the wire will experience a net magnetic force onto it. So always remember, in case of a static charge only electric field can exert a force on it. In case of a moving charge, both electric and magnetic fields can exert force on it. And in case of a current carrying wire, only magnetic field can exert a force on it. Electric force will not be exerted on the wire because net sum of all charges on this wire is equal to zero as it is electrically neutral.